catfish, and these are our catfish, and we're gonna fillet them, and we are going to get started. The reason why I have the paper towel down is so I can hold the catfish better and it don't slip around. So when you go to do this, make sure you have a paper towel down. I'm gonna get about to right here. Then I'm gonna hit it like that. And this makes it easier if you go ahead and have everything set up so you don't have to, like, where's this at? Where's that at? Just do the same thing on the other side. Probably help if I started at the right end. But we're going to cook all this, and it's going to be good. Except for these little parts. I don't like those parts. And I'm going to cut the tail off. Some people like the tail. I don't really care for the tail. Cut this little piece of meat off right there. And just do the same thing on the other side. Then, you know, once you do this, you'll be like, there ain't nothing to it. Just hit it again like that. Sometimes you might have to cut on it. There we go. That's a good little piece of meat right there. I actually tried to catch some catfish today and I did not succeed. I've only caught a turtle. It was a alligator snapping turtle. It was a little bitty thing. Just go ahead and cut this little piece of meat right here. Just be careful when you're doing this, because like I said, even on the paper towel, it's still sliding. There we go. And then just, you can keep the tail. I don't prefer to keep the tail. I don't care for that. These are nothing but little fins on the fish. That's a good piece of meat right there. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we are going to get another paper towel. And you need to make sure you do this, because if you don't dry your fish off, the cornmeal will not stick to your fish. You can see I already have my cornmeal right here, so it just makes it easier when you have everything set up nice, because it goes easier. Just kind of pat it dry. Yeah, when I show you how to do this, you'll be like, oh wow, that's easy, I can do that. Like I said, there's nothing to this. Okay, now I'm gonna rinse my hands off real quick. And these are the seasonings that I mixed up. You can use any kind of seasonings that you want. This is just cornmeal. That's all it is. It's not self-rising, just regular cornmeal. That's all we're putting in here. We're just going to dump it in there like that. Then you're going to kind of stir it around like that. Make sure you get it all mixed up real good. Then you're going to take your fish, push it down in there. Rub it all over it. Push it in there. Rub it all over it. And I already had a pan that had some oil in it, so it's already over there getting nice and warm for it. And I'm going to show y'all a trick to how you can tell when your oil is ready. Come up over here, please. See, when it does that, that's how you know your oil's ready. When it makes that sizzle. So, I'm going to take the rest of these fish. I'm going to dip them down in there like that. Just push it down in there. Make sure you get it all over the fish. You can use whatever you want to put your cornmeal in. I just used this because it was big enough to put the fish in. And to me, my favorite type of fish is catfish. So that's what I was raised up on eating, was catfish. Just kind of get them all on it. So what we're doing. Okay. So now I'm going to take my pan and put it right here. We're going to put them in here. Just like that. And you do not want to use a fork when you're doing this, because if you stick a fork in it, that grease is going to get in there. The oil. And you don't want it getting in the fish. That's why I'm using these. Yeah, we're just going to let this kind of sit for a little while and just let it cook. And I'll probably flip it over here in just a little bit, and we'll be right back. Okay, we're back, and you can see the fish is still cooking. I'm just going to flip them over a little bit. And you can tell when they're done because they'll be brown. Yeah, just be real careful when you're doing this, because this is some hot oil. And also, we're going to make some french fries with this, but we're just going to use a fry daddy, so it'll just be a little side that goes with it. But yeah, they pretty much just cook themselves. You just stand here and watch it, make sure it don't burn. But the reason why you tell it's done is that, see how this is starting to turn brown right here? The whole fish will start turning that color when it gets done. But yep, that is how I like to cook my catfish. And we'll come back when this looks like it's getting closer to being done. We'll be back in just a little bit. Okay, we're back. So here's our fish, and they are still cooking, but you can already see that they're already turning that golden brown on them. This one's almost done. But this is what we want them to look like, is this. Just be careful, because this grease will pop you. It's hot. But catfish is another good summertime food to eat. That's why I wanted to do this video, because I was like, that would be a good video to do, is catfish. Fried catfish. Yeah, that's got a real nice, pretty color to it. It's almost done. We'll go ahead and take this one out so y'all can see what it looks like. Like I said, don't jab it, because if you jab it, you are going to have grease all in your fish. That's how you can tell it's done, too. It's got that real pretty white meat in there. That's going to be good. But I'm going to go ahead and get these other ones cooked, which I think these are about done, too. This one looks good. Did you get that?
Mm-hmm. Pretty fish.
Catfish. See, there ain't really nothing to cooking catfish. I used to think when I was growing up, this catfish is so amazing that my granny makes, and I used to think she stood there for hours and cooked it because it was just so amazing. But now that I'm grown, I can tell, you know, this stuff ain't hard to make at all. It's just taking the time to make it, and that's what makes it good. But that is how you make fried catfish. If I had some fresh lemons, I'd put it on top of this, but I don't. So I'm just gonna put some on this one right here. Like that. That's probably still really hot, but I'm gonna try a piece of it anyways. Life club. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and I hope y'all can make y'all some fried catfish, and please like and subscribe, and have a good day.